Summer 92, you know. It was about 20 guys staying at my house at the time. You know, Snoop, Warren, all the guys that were on the Chronic that were involved in that album. And when I would stop in the studio, they would go down there and start, you know, fucking around with the drum machines and shit. You know, had the shit cranking all night, learning the shit, you know. I would come in and show him a few things every now and then, but he basically picked it up on his own, you know. And I was like I was telling you, I don't know. Motherfucker was gonna be 2 million copies a couple of years later. I'd have been down there a little bit more, you know.
When you listen to the G'd up sound, Pioneer speakers bumping as I smoke on the pound. I got the sound for your ass, and it's easy to see that this DJ be
kind of easy when you listen to the G'd up sound. Why would he even say the word easy? You know what I'm saying? When he say easy, you think of easily listening. This music is ill. But what makes it the most interesting to me about the whole thing is he's Dr. Dre's little brother. That takes my mind to a whole nother realm when I think. So Dr. Dre's selling millions, and you were supposed to have Snoop, is from what I understand. Snoop was your man, so Dre took him and put him out, and you waited in the boondocks. And now they gotta give him his.
His own style, he didn't, you know, didn't use none of the shit that I do, you know, none of my sounds or none of that shit. He just came out and did his own thing, came up with his own shit, which is dope.
Excuse me!
I love the beat, lyrics. I've always listened to it. You know, white people getting into it.
You got some zigzags? Huh? You got some zigzags? Oh, did they hear me say that?
Stand back and give me some room, because when this is over,
seven dice.
I'm going to need a broom.
A boy don't need a broom.
Oh, seven anything dice. But a...
I bet on the five. I picked up.
I wish niggas could come and say no over the money, I know that. I know his motherfucking point, nigga. I know what the hell I bet it. Hello?
Conjunction. Yeah. What's my function? Yeah. I'm hooking up tracks so that niggas can function. Uh-huh. It's not Pete Rock or that nigga Dr. Dre. It's this motherfucking nigga from around the way. The one that brings you styles on time. D1D, that's why so far define me. Conduction and construction when I bust. Choo-choo busters. Yeah. It's a must when I bust, when I bust. I gotta come correct. The R to the E to the SBA architect. Yep, nigga, no, I'm not tweaking. Yeah. It's one of the 16 minds that I'm spitting. Hey, the W-A, the double R, the E into the A, B, C, D, E, F to the motherfucking G. Holy shit, as I flex, I rex, I check. The what's next?
All right. Everybody, you know.
This is Warren G, you know what I'm saying?
And is it going platinum yet, Johnny? It's platinum now.
Almost double.
Double.
It'll be double by the end of next week.
Explain to them what double means. Platinum.
2 million records. Copies, you know, tapes. CDs, tapes.
Okay.
So.
Hey, Warren G. Hey, Warren G.
What?
You gotta hurry up. Coolio already on.
I just want to be able to talk to somebody.
So I ain't gonna get to do nothing, huh?
Let me quit. You can
this
do it
happened in every city, every, and then I
no,
had to leave.
No, this doesn't happen every city.
5 footers in the house. This is a 5 foot session. Neb is in the house, motherfucker. I'm not stressing. At my best and on the microphone, it's me, the NEB, feeling Irie. When I hit the spliff, I got the gift to a bliff. Any nigga or negro with the fro in the back, yo. Pass the flow to my homegirl, Josh Skills. Beatboxing, cuz we're on the real.
So, what's up with the 5 footers?
We can work this out, but what they don't like, so I guess they're gonna send in conditions. I guess they want the hairdresser.
Yeah, no. I ain't paying for the shit.
Come on, Warren. Every group has the hairdresser.
I ain't paying for no motherfucking hairdresser. If they want that shit, but be my guest.
Sorry, I think
I'm supposed to just say fuck them and change the motherfucker.
You can do the hair. We're braided.
They got braids in their hair, so what? I mean, what's that?
This is called ghetto burning. When you burn your hair, when it starts frizzing.
They got braids in their hair, but they need a hairdresser. What else you say, Uncle Ronnie?
Basically, wish he would firm up a little earlier in the game than waiting until he has to blow up. He makes his own decisions.
Conditions, this. They act like I'm getting paid $60,000 or something. I'm just saying, all this trying to be business, talking about conditions, and this is the conditions we...
Conditions for what?
Hey, Neb, if y'all gonna come, y'all gonna have to let us know something. We gotta know today for sure.
They still have a production contract with Warren.
I mean, you
let them out of the contract?
Yeah. If they really wanna get out, bye.
Well, let's ask them again.
I ain't about holding nobody. That's what it is about me.
We work the situation
If I ain't gonna work with you, what's the use of me holding you?
Still, there's another difference, and there's another difference.
I'll let you go. It ain't no thing to me, because you're not making me or breaking me. The music industry break. If when you come in as friends, it breaks you up. It breaks you up. Got them 5 swiggies in their pocket.
It ain't them. It's their man.
Well, he twisting their ass up. He about to fuck them up.
You just tell us what you want, and let's get on with this tour. And incidentally, Gil, you're not holding the tour up because we did our first night last night.
And blew it
and
up.
And it was the shit.
That's Ron G at his best, baby. At his best. That's why my business is taken care of so swell.